After successfully upgrading Centurion tanks to the Olifant Mk1A standard and further enhancing the design with the Olifant Mk1B, South African engineers embarked on developing a new domestically produced main battle tank prototype known as the Tank Technology Demonstrator, or TTD for short. This vehicle was designed as a testbed for cutting-edge advancements in firepower, mobility, and survivability, rather than as a direct response to any specific external threat. The TTD aimed to integrate the latest tank technologies of the time, positioning South Africa as a leader in armored vehicle innovation. Kurbi Kotse, South Africa's defense minister from 1993 to 1994, claimed that the TTD was on par with international systems like the Leopard 2A4 and the American Abrams M1A1. Whether this assertion was accurate remains unknown, as the project was ultimately canceled. The government prioritized modernizing the Air Force and Navy, leaving the TTD as a remarkable yet unrealized chapter in South Africa's defense history. Since the mid-1970s, South Africa found itself under the United Nations arms embargo due to their apartheid policies, which made acquisition of the new MBTs impossible. South Africa's inventory of MBTs in the early 1980s consisted of domestically improved Centurion tanks in the form of Olifant Mk1 and Mk1A. Subsequently, the South African Defense Force identified the need to develop a new generation of MBT indigenously. This need led to the launch of Project Lochim, undertaken by several South African companies, including Roymec Olifant and Littleton Engineering Works. Through this project, the Tank Technology Demonstrator was created to demonstrate local development capabilities which would inform the feasibility of South Africa to develop and build its own new generation MBT. Despite the drastic reduction in defense funding following the conclusion of the South African Border War in 1989, the TTD project had advanced significantly. By 1992, the prototype was completed under the supervision of the Armaments Corporation of South Africa and the SADF. However, following South Africa's first democratic elections in 1994 and the lifting of the UN arms embargo, the newly formed South African National Defense Force, or SANDF, launched Project Aorta to reassess its armored vehicle needs. While the TTD proved that South Africa could produce a new generation MBT, it would not be in its best financial interest given the determined need for 108 vehicles, of which 96 would be MBTs and 12 to be armored recovery vehicles and bridge layers. Given the quantities needed, it was determined that procuring modern MBTs from the international market would be more economical, leading to the TTD project's cancellation. The design, development, and production of the TTD aimed to demonstrate the potential of creating an indigenous new generation MBT. The TTD's design allowed for easy optimization based on mission requirements with customizable subsystems. A key design requirement for the TTD was the ability to self-deploy quickly over long distances by road if transport vehicles were unavailable. The TTD features a twin-turbo intercooled V8 diesel engine which is governed to produce 1,234 horsepower, allowing acceleration from 0 to 30 kilometers an hour in 5.1 seconds and a top speed of 71 kilometers an hour on roads. The engine's water-to-air cooling system reduces its infrared signature by mixing warm exhaust gases with cooled air. The power pack includes a management system that regulates power output at temperatures up to 48 degrees Celsius. The TTD uses an automatic gearbox with 4 forward and 2 reverse gears, and the final drives handle up to 1,500 horsepower. To improve fuel efficiency, the engine switches from 8 to 4 cylinders when stationary. The steering system allows pivot turns and variable steering, with turning circles of 15 meters at low speed and 36 meters at high speed. The suspension consists of torsion bars, friction rotary dampers, and hydraulic bump stops, providing stability and low noise. The live track system has 7 rubber-tire dual road wheels, a front idler, a rear driving sprocket, and 4 return rollers, with a ground pressure of 0.93 kilograms per square centimeter. The TTD can climb a 60-degree gradient, a 30-degree side slope, and cross a 3.5-meter trench and ford 1.5 meters of water unprepared. The TTD uses between 102 and 112 track links depending on the tension, with road wheels mounted on a torsion bar system with 500 millimeters of vertical travel. The impact energy on the road wheels is absorbed by wear-resistant, maintenance-free, hydraulic variable-resistance friction dampers and hydraulic bump stops. The braking system is integrated into the gearbox and comprises a primary retarder and double-disc serve brakes, allowing it to stop from 56 kilometers an hour in 6.8 seconds. The brakes are air-cooled, and the hydraulic start system is available if the electrical system fails. An important design requirement of the TTD was the ability to operate independently from workshop support and be maintainable by reservists. It has a 1,600-liter diesel fuel tank, providing a road range of 400 kilometers and a cross-country range of 300 kilometers at 35 kilometers an hour. On sandy terrain, the range drops to 150 kilometers. The TTD can reverse at maximum speed at 32 kilometers an hour. Enhanced with advanced tactical radio communication, the TTD ensured reliable command and control, enhancing battlefield effectiveness. The interior design was ergonomic and minimized acoustic noise as much as possible, which reduced crew fatigue and improved situational awareness. Planned armaments included a 7.62 coaxial Browning machine gun with a 2,000-round bin and an optional 7.62mm general-purpose machine gun mounted on the roof. For crew comfort, the TTD has an 80-liter internal drinking water tank accessible from the loaders and driver stations. A fume extractor fan clears the crew compartment of excess fumes produced by the main gun's firing. The TTD has a crew of four: a commander, gunner, loader, and driver. The commander station on the right side of the turret features a sunken cupola with a 360-degree view through six periscopes, traditional mechanical sights, and a CS-60N stabilized commander sight with a 3X and 10X magnification, including a night vision channel. Below the commander station is the gunner station with day-night capabilities. Both the commander and gunner would have had digital display screens in the final production variant. They access their stations via the commander's hatch. The loader station on the left side of the turret has its own hatch and an episcope for better situational awareness. The driver station includes an ergonomic design with an analog instrument panel and a yoke-type steering stick. Three episcopes provide visibility, with the central one replaceable by a night-driving periscope. The driver accesses his station through a hatch above and has an emergency escape hatch underneath the seat. Digital screens would have been added in the final MBT variant. The TTD's passive armor includes multiple layers of spaced armor with a 750mm thick frontal glassy. The turret armor details are still classified even though the project was canceled. The front hull and turret are described as capable of withstanding 125mm APF SDS and heat rounds, while the sides and rear protect against 23mm AP rounds. The top armor can resist 155mm air burst rounds, and the bottom hull is rated against anti-tank mine blasts. Reactive armor plating can be added for extra protection, and the design was very similar to that found on the Leopard 2A5. The TTD has an automatic fire and explosion suppression system with optical detectors in the turret and driver's compartment. Built-in blow-off panels are incorporated into the first stage ammunition storage to minimize the risk to the crew in the event of an explosion. The engine compartment has an automatic and manual fire extinguishing system, and the fuel tank uses Explosafe to prevent pressure buildup from ignited vapors. Biological and chemical protection is provided by seals, an overpressure system, and an air filtration system with individual BC protection for the crew. The TTD has a cooling system for crew comfort and to reduce the vehicle's IR signature. The interior is lined with an anti-spalling layer as well. It also features 81mm smoke grenade launchers and an exhaust smoke generating system. For testing purposes, the TTD is fitted with a standard 105mm GT3 QF semi-automatic main gun developed by Littleton Engineering Works. The gun is encased in a thermal shield and can depress negative 10 degrees and elevate a positive 20 degrees. A total of 54 main gun rounds are carried, of which 6 are kept in the turret basket, 16 rounds are kept in a rotating carousel, and 32 in ammunition racks to the left of the driver. Available rounds include APF SDSTs, heat rounds, HESH rounds, and HET rounds. The production variant would have featured a 120mm smoothbore barrel. A provision in the turret design was also made for the potential fitting of a larger 140mm smoothbore barrel. Tests showed high accuracy against T-72-sized targets at 2 kilometers while on the move, with over 75% accuracy and 84% accuracy while stationary. The gun drive uses a 48-volt brushless DC motor for rapid turret rotation. Additionally, to help in aiming, a laser rangefinder with a 200 to 8,000 meter range was integrated with a 120 element thermal imager, which is projected on monitors at both the commander and gunner stations. Ammunition is stored in the turret and floor, with a rotating carousel at the rear right of the turret supplying rounds to the loader. The fire control system of the TTD utilizes an RS-485 serial data bus to connect all subsystems, enabling efficient hunter-killer mode where both the gunner and commander can independently search for enemy targets. Once a target is identified, the gunner or commander can slave the main gun onto the target with an override option. A compact 48-volt DC electromechanical gun drive with an integrated digital FCS is used for fire direction. The system's reaction time from target acquisition to firing is less than 9 seconds. It also calculates ballistic offsets and enhances first-round hit probability by considering various factors, such as the TTD's tilt angle and speed, target movement, crosswind, barometric pressure, temperature, ammunition conditions, and target distance. The incorporated muzzle reference system ensures precise calibration. The FCS calculates ballistic data with high accuracy and speed, with a cycle time of 5 microseconds. Lieutenant Colonel Kunred Klopper of the SA Army Armor Formation provided a summary of the TTD, highlighting its advanced suspension, tracks, and drive lines similar to the Leopard 2. However, shortcomings were noted in the gun drive system and power pack, which were adapted extensively from the MTU ship generator engine. The transmission was considered outdated for modern MBTs, and the turret had issues with its stabilizing system and fire control system, falling short of desired specifications. With enough time and funding, all these issues would have ultimately been ironed out, and Klopper believes the TTD could still be effective on the modern battlefield with appropriate upgrades to its fire control and gun drive systems. In the mid-1990s, the TTD represented the height of South Africa's technological capabilities. However, the cancellation of the Lochim project and the absence of new MBT orders led to the TTD being donated to the SA Armor Museum in 1997. Rather than investing in the Army and its need for a new MBT by purchasing tanks from abroad, the South African government chose to prioritize upgrades for the Air Force and the Navy. This decision left the SANDF without a modern MBT. To address this gap, the shortcomings of the existing Olifant Mk1B were identified, and an upgrade program was initiated to meet the SANDF's needs. In 2005, a total of 26 Olifant Mk1B tanks were upgraded to the Olifant Mk2 standard, integrating several subsystems initially developed for the TTD. This concludes our video on South Africa's ambitious attempt to develop a modern MBT with the Tank Technology Demonstrator. Do you think the TTD would have been a game changer or a liability on the battlefield if the project had been allowed to continue? How do you think it would have stacked up against its contemporary tanks like the Leopard 2, M1 Abrams, or Challenger 2? Share your opinions in the comments section below. And if you haven't done so already, we invite you to subscribe to stay updated on future content. And if you'd like to contribute further, consider supporting us on Patreon or PayPal. We especially want to thank our medium and heavy tank Patreon supporters, Andrew Oberg, Dan Fitzpatrick, Dave Schuford, Leslie Holkauer, Michael Herman, Owen M., Peter Bradbury, and Wolf Hund. Your generous contributions help fund our research, illustrations, and video production. To everyone else, thank you for watching, and until next time, keep us in your sights.